How can you tell the age of a horse by the teeth? Also, I bet you know that dogs' teeth should be brushed daily or they could produce teeth, gum, jawbone diseases. And she's wondering if a horse's teeth should be brushed daily or weekly. And what type of teeth, gum, jawbone diseases can a horse get? And what are the most common? And what are some ways to prevent any teeth, gum, jawbone diseases?
Wow. So what was her name?
So Emily.
Emily must have been listening, because didn't you ask someone to ask about how you age a horse
yes,
by their teeth?
Yeah. I did.
Yeah, so she was
smart.
Listening. So I found this book. This is the guide for determining the age of the horse. You want to guess what year this is?
The AAEP puts out the most fascinating titles.
I know.
2002.
So it's 15 years old. I think they have this electronically now.
2002 was 15 years ago, you guys.
This was a fun book because it's got eruption schedule, which is super helpful.
Ooh.
It is the most accurate way to age a horse, because as they're losing baby teeth and gaining permanent teeth, that's pretty accurate. Like the incisors for the foal are 6 days, 6 weeks, 6 months.
Mm.
So nice little. And then when they lose those incisors, it's 2.5 years, 3.5 years, 4.5 years. So it's a nice little.
Okay. Nice cadence.
Jingle.
Yeah.
And then.
Singing that one to yourself.
The tooth comes in, let's say the central incisors, at 2.5 years. It takes 6 months to be what's called in wear. And that means grow to touch the bottom one.
Mm-hmm.
So from birth to about 5 years, you can age pretty accurately. After that, it gets to be more of an art. And after 10, 15 years, it's even not really an art. It's kind of more like voodoo. But this book has great pictures. It talks about the eruption.
Mm-hmm.
I'll just read their indicators. And you can see how complicated it is and how it can be not very accurate, because it does depend a little bit on the breed of the horse or
mm-hmm.
pony, what they're eating
mm-hmm.
can change a lot, the dental care they've received in their life, but the length versus the width
okay.
of the upper corner incisor.
Oh.
Because it's when they're young, it's wider than it is long, and as they age, it gets longer and skinnier.
Because
remember that horses' teeth grow throughout their lives. So
that's why you have to float them.
Right. They are wider at the beginning, and as they get more of their root, it gets narrower. Which leads to one of the problems is gum disease as they age, because there begins to be spaces between the cheek teeth, which we haven't talked about yet, but those spaces can lead to gum disease, gingivitis, periodontal disease. Periodontal meaning gum and bone.
Mm.
So as far as problems, it's what you said. Because their teeth grow all the time, you have to float them and take off the sharp edges. And the sharp edges are on the outside mm-hmm. of the uppers and the inside of the lowers, because the jaw, the lower jaw, is narrower.
Mm-hmm.
So those teeth, they meet, but there's a little bit sticking into the inside, the tongue side on the bottom.
Mm-hmm.
So we have to float those. That's the number one problem horses get. They can get cavities, but they don't really. So we don't brush them. And it has to do with the infolding and the invaginations and the complicated way their teeth are created versus other species, their diet.
Mm-hmm.
They're not eating a lot of sugary, sticky treats. The fact that they're trickle feeders, they eat all the time, so they get the very alkaline saliva that
mm-hmm.
bathes their mouth. So there's some reasons that horses don't get cavities and don't need brushed, that they need floated. That's the care that your veterinarian is going to be doing every 6 months or a year based on exams.